Welcome to summer. Special Olympics Edmonton is super excited that we are able to host summer programs. The programs we are going to be able to host this summer will look a little bit different than what you're used to, and a little bit different than what other groups you will see out in the community doing. Due to the fact that we are serving a vulnerable population, we will have more guidelines and restrictions than perhaps a generic sport group. Please follow along during this presentation so you will know exactly what to expect when you show up at programs. Thanks! When arriving to your program, we ask that you arrive no more than 10 minutes prior to avoid crowding. You must wear a mask upon arrival and will not be allowed to take it off until directed by a coach. You will also be required to sanitize your hands prior to the start of the program. As always, we recommend to practice proper hygiene. Washing your hands before and after practice, do not touch your face, and avoid touching frequently touched surfaces when at practice. We ask you to come prepared for the program as you may not have access to indoor changing facilities. You will also undergo a mandatory screening upon arrival. We'll be asking a set of questions that you can view on the screen. We will also be screening for symptoms. If you answer yes to any of the questions or exhibit COVID symptoms, you will be asked to isolate and be required to be picked up directly from the program. To be eligible to return to the program, you will need to send a negative test to the office. We will be maintaining the 6 feet apart or 2 meters apart rule for the duration of the program. Masks may be taken off during activity as directed by a coach, but must be worn should you come within 6 feet of another member at a program. If your coach is working one-to-one with you, they will be required to wear a mask. Spectators must not interact with the group, but are welcome at the program. They are expected to watch from a distance. If your athlete requires one-to-one support, that support must also undergo the screening and follow the masking and social distancing protocols as they are considered as part of the group. One-to-one supports will need to provide their contact information for contact tracing purposes. We will be minimizing equipment use and sanitizing all equipment before and after use. We are asking that equipment to not be shared among athletes and sanitize between use should it need to be shared for any reason. We are minimizing the use of indoor facilities and washrooms unless it's an emergency. Please plan to use the washroom before you arrive at programs. At this time, there will be no gameplay permitted during the programs. However, things can change, and should we get clearance from Special Olympics Alberta, gameplay may be permitted later in the season. We will keep you posted. All masks must be worn as you depart the program, and we ask that you plan to leave immediately afterwards to avoid crowds. We also ask that any equipment that was used during the duration of the program be sanitized, stored, and put away properly. We understand that our guidelines may be frustrating to some, as other groups do not have the same restrictions as we do. However, as mentioned previously, we are a vulnerable population and we must do everything we can to keep our members safe. As we are given clearance from Special Olympics Alberta, we may be able to lift some of these restrictions later in the season. We encourage you to visit the Special Olympics Alberta website and review the full return to play plan, specifically the protocols around a positive case. We are hoping for a full reopening in the fall. Stay tuned, and we can't wait to see you.